The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
This gotta be something for me to write this, queen. I ain't seen you in a minute. Wrote this letter and finally decide to send it. Signed, sealed, delivered for us to grow together. Love has no limit, let's spin a slow forever. I know your heart is weathered by what does did to you. I ain't gon' start them cause I probably did it too. Because of you feelings I handle with care. Some niggas recognize your life but they can handle the glare. You know I ain't the type to walk around with matching shirts. A relationship is effort, I will match your work. I wanna be the one to make you happiest and hurt you the most. They say the end is near, it's important that we close to the most high. Regardless of what happened, on him let's rely.
There are times when you need someone.
Yeah. Second, it's important we communicate and tune the fate of this union to the right pitch. I never call you my bitch or even my boo. It's so much in the name and so much more than you. Few understand the union of woman and man. And sex and a tingle is where they assuming it land. But that's fly by night for you in the sky right. During these cold shine nights, moon, you my light. If heaven had a height, you would be that tall. Ghetto to coffee shop, if I see that all. Let's stick to understanding and we won't fall. For better or worse times, I hope to me you call. So I pray every day more than anything. Friends will stay as we begin to lay this foundation for a family. Love ain't simple, why can't it be anything worth having? You work at annually. Granted, we've known each other for some time. It don't take a whole day to recognize sunshine.
These are the days, man. Generation U Radio, we back. Hey, listen, I know we come in sometimes with the reggae. Sometimes we come in with the other shit. But today we came in smooth, baby. Shout out to all of the people out there. Turn my music down. There you go. Shout out to everybody in the building, man. We got another hot show for y'all. Another hot topic today. Generation U Radio. You can hit that little one. Oh, yeah, I'm not cussing. I'm trying my best.
Doing a good job so far.
Thank you, but it's only 30.
Minute number one.
It's only been 30 seconds.
Not even a minute.
Anyway, man, my name is Scott Taylor, a.k.a. Scotty Trippin. You can turn my music down just a little bit. And in the building, we got...
Hello, everyone. This is Melanie Eke, and I just want to say happy Friday and happy National Donut Day.
Oh, man.
Just FYI, I have a treat for all of you. I brought donuts.
Hit her with a round of applause. Thank you very much.
Is that for me? It got bacon?
In honor of National Donut Day. But in order to get your donut, I have to just let you guys know why we celebrate this day. So in World War I, the Salvation Army donut dollies used to distribute donuts to the soldiers on the front line.
Turn the music a little down.
And so that's why we have National Donut Day. And I thought that was just a really interesting piece of our history to hit them with another
round of applause.
They got apple fritters.
Yeah.
Learn something new every day.
Yeah. Taking care of our soldiers with donuts. Yeah. Who would have thought? So now everybody gets donuts. Enjoy.
Hey,
you crack them open. You're welcome.
I'm on a diet right now.
All right, then more for me.
Anyway, man, let's keep it pushing real quick, man. I got my girl in the building. Tell the people what your name is.
Hi, it's Naya B.
Hit her with a round of applause, please.
You
looking good. I see you with your onesie on.
Trying. I did my 5K.
Oh, so no.
That's right. The color. What was it? The color run.
Run. Mm-hmm.
Now explain the color run so people don't get offended.
It's like taken from like an Indian. What'd you say? It's taken from an Indian tradition, like the run of colors or something like that. But basically, you run for 3.5 miles and they splatter you with color powder.
Oh,
this shit is weak.
So they was throwing.
Throwing anthrax.
Yes.
Anthrax.
It was going to be like.
Hit them with a disclaimer, man. I like how you jumped in there. Team White Skin.
It's like bottled power, and they're like in your face, and I'm like, okay, blind me while I'm running, thanks. But it was actually really, really fun. And I,
money
you know,
shot.
It's something that you do to like take selfies and Snapchat the entire time. Most people weren't even running, so you know. I was mad, but I'm going to do the Mud Runner next.
Mud Runner? Yeah. Hey, listen, if you are on Rodeo Avenue, call in and make sure you subscribe to that Mud Run. I feel like that's going to be something to watch. You know? I'm just playing.
Here we go.
Let's keep it pushing real quick. Hey, listen, man, I got my man in the building, fresh off the game one win. Hit him with a round of applause one time.
Game one.
After coming from behind.
Anyway, that's your boy William Basham. You know, like you said, coming in hard like Golden State in game one. We out here.
Oh, that's right. Hey, listen, that's gonna be a good series though. Don't.
It's gonna be good until game.
Don't sleep on LeBron, baby.
Stop it. Warriors got this. They got this bag.
Hey, you seen at the end of the game, man? They was killing that last that fourth quarter of game one was crazy.
They didn't even have their all stars putting in work like that.
They didn't.
Yeah. The bench dropped 45 points.
45 from the bench.
How you let the man whose knee went this way take over the game?
They had a great game though, man. It's good to see. You know, it's good to see. I don't know if they're the underdog, but it was good. It was crazy to watch them come back. You know,
the Warriors.
Absolutely not.
They wasn't.
I mean, not anymore, but they were the underdog.
How are they the underdog when they won 73 games?
Because
they're in the hardest conference.
Because I think she's saying in the grand scheme of
LeBron,
things, like,
it's LeBron. Like, I mean, they're the underdog. They're the defending. What you mean? Like,
I'm just saying, how are they the underdog?
Shut up.
Hit her with a disclaimer.
I think she's saying before they started winning.
I think she's referring to back in the day when Warrior tickets
used to be practically free because nobody went to go see the Oakland Warriors.
Hit her with a round of applause.
I think that's what she's talking about. And they kind of came out of nowhere and started winning.
Listen, man, it's crazy all the new Golden State fans that we got now. I swear, all y'all, I didn't see y'all a couple years ago.
State fans. Right. Golden State fans out the blue.
Right.
Will never strayed from the course. He's always been the same. So anyway, we're going to keep it pushing real quick, man. We got a guest comedian in the building, man.
Yes.
I see you with your dog tags. Now, tell the people what's your name, bro.
Jay Washington in the building, man. Oh, this dog tag was given to me by my son for Christmas.
Hit him a motherfucker around.
Okay. So don't even think. I am PMR'd from the military. I'm permanently medically released.
Hey.
I told him I had asthma. I can't breathe. I had asthma. I was like, I ain't gonna.
You know what? The air index ain't
they
really.
They was trying to get me to go right after September 11th. I was like, can't do it.
You came to Meps with the inhaler. Yeah,
Meps, I was like, it's not gonna happen, sir.
Melanie, William over here wants
the
donuts.
What
type of donuts?
The donuts was like, y'all, I can't even get around the room without the soldiers' diabetes.
Yeah, you can have one.
Oh my goodness.
I'll just pass.
All right, chill out. All right, we got to keep it pushing, man. I got my man in the building real quick. Tell the people what you can. You get on the mic because we don't have the cordless mics this week, man. I see you with your jacket on. We gonna get into that.
Oh yeah, you know I'm bombing on him again.
Get him,
Shaman Chriso.
Chriso with the bomber jacket.
Yeah.
Hey. One time. I see you.
Right.
The nigga looks shiny to me.
Right.
Nah, hold on, real talk though. I got this new merchandise about to come out.
On my shoulder.
Oh shit. Right.
I see that. Hit him with a round of applause, man. Hey man,
come out soon.
I seen your name buzzing on the internet. I was like, I see you on the Jazzy Faye side of things.
Yeah.
Hit him with a round of applause.
Good job. An organic one, man.
Song is dope.
Hey, getting it though. I see you. I see your grandmama gave you that chain, huh?
Don't worry about her life.
It was a gift.
Grandmama gave you that chain.
His grandma, look out.
Oh shit.
Let him live.
Right?
Right, let him live, man. Anyway, we're going to keep it pushing, man. I got my girl in the building.
Hey,
Trainer Cakes in the mug. Can hit her with a round of applause.
How is everybody? Happy Friday.
Yes. Happy Friday.
You're looking great.
Thank you.
All right, listen, I saw you on Facebook. Because we're great Facebook friends.
So,
you was on top of 45 pound weight? Or it was like 45?
So, 4 45s. Wow. And I couldn't get my foot on the last one, but I feel like that was almost more challenging. So, I was planking on 4 45s.
Mm.
Yeah. It was insane. Maybe about like 3 or 4 seconds, but you know, it's a start.
Definitely hit her with a round of applause.
Trainer Cakes.
He's like, yes.
Hashtag I am.
She got a good core.
The captain. She got of a the good Thirst core. Squad. Hey. Fitness.
Can you hit Thirst Squad with a round of applause? Y'all thought.
I graduated. waiting.
And she's gonna be the captain of the admin gang. She's gonna be the admin captain.
The fitness program.
The fitness program. Okay.
Don't get it twisted.
Actual fitness.
Calm down.
Don't make me blush.
Hey, and you're a very positive person, man. I really like your posts. I really like watching you.
Too.
I really do. I think that you're dope.
I follow you on Snapchat.
Support
too.
You.
Thank you.
We're gonna keep it pushing. Hey, we got Kim Cardiel in the background looking outstanding real quick.
Hey.
Can you say what's
Shout
up?
Out.
Can you say what's up real quick, or is it too much?
What's up?
she's been fading into the background lately, I've noticed. She's been doing a lot of background. It's okay.
Hey, it's good, man. We're going to keep it pushing real quick. We got another guest in the building, man. Tell the people what's your name. That's you, man.
That's me. Ryan Rondeno, a.k.a.
Pick him up.
Chef Ryan.
Dola Chef.
I feel like I've seen you before.
And he's got a special surprise for us a little bit later. We're not going to talk about that yet, though.
Wait.
Not yet.
No, I swear.
No donuts.
No donuts. You got donuts over here, though.
Is it green?
I got my man Chris
Green.
I got my man Chris Hudson. Chris Hudson in the building, LA Music Attorney. That's your handle, right? Yeah. LA Music Attorney. You can follow him on Instagram.
He goes to all the events.
Or you can call him on his pager, but he don't know y'all. I'm just telling you. I got my man in the building, my DJ, man. Can you tell the people what's going on with you one time, please? Is the mic not working?
No.
Just yell. No, come on the mic. I'm just playing, man. Come up on the mic real quick.
It's not working.
Bring him over here because we want to make sure that we shout our DJ out, man.
Respect
the DJ. Go ahead and talk on it.
Oh, yeah, it's the deal. It's your boy Jay. Oh,
I got it. There you go.
It's your boy Jay Switch, you feel me? Up in the building. Mr. Handsworth Bands are coming out this Sunday at the Jay Spot DJ.
Yeah.
Let them know, you feel me?
He ain't old enough to be there.
But I'm in there, though.
He gonna have the X's on his hands, but he'll be there.
Don't tell nobody. I'm in there, though. I'm in there.
Yeah. I got the juice.
It don't matter, because he good anyway. He can do it regardless.
I
see with your chain on. Looking. Yeah.
In the carton with a straw.
Hey, man, we gonna keep pushing.
Pre-game before. Better not. Game potty mouth.
Time up at the J Spot with a Capri Sun.
Right.
Hey, we turned up in here today, man. I got my girl Leanne in the building. Leanne took
it. Man, you want to say something?
I got my man Aaron in the building. Hit Aaron with a round of applause one time. I appreciate you guys coming out and taking the pictures for us, man. Shout out to Glenn. He can't make it today. Shout out to my girl Potty Mouth, too, man, doing what she do, holding us down. Shout out to Alexia, you know, and everybody else that makes this show possible, man. Hey, go ahead and cue up our second song real quick, man. Well, I'm going to tell you all this topic. All right, check it out. Today's topic, man, we got a real special one, man. It's Generation U Radio. At Gen U Radio on YouTube if you get a chance. The topic today is the Common Sense Show, baby. Turn my music up a little bit. And then you can hit the round of applause. Thank you, engineer. Hey, we got to shout out our engineer, man. He does a great job. So today's topic is the Common Sense Show, baby. Why? Not when or where. Why is common sense not common? In other words, why are people so dumb? Why do we do this to ourselves? Nah, for real, though. You know what I'm saying? What's the difference between book smarts and sweet kid street smarts, you know? Do you need just one? Do you need to have both? Can you get along with just one?
Kill them with both.
You can kill them with both.
Damn, you got both.
You kill the game if you got both. But you got to know the difference. Where do you learn these things? Who teaches you? Who teaches you the
speech?
Where do you learn?
Right. In 2016, that's where they're learning it.
VH1 and Instagram teaches.
Listen, man. Where do you learn your street smarts? It's Generation U Radio, at Gen U Radio. You know what I'm saying? Get us a chance. Make sure to subscribe. Turn my music down just a little bit. If you get a chance, man, make sure to subscribe to our network, man. We out here for the people. Support the people. Support the art. Support the movement. Shout out to my sponsors. I got Gorilla Life. Got Pitbull Energy Drink. Roscoe's Chicken and Waffle. My name is Scott Taylor, man. Scotty Trippin. If you get a chance, you want to check out my music, man, it's scottytrippin.com. scottietrippin.com. If you want to check out the radio show itself, man, you can go and check out all of our shit, man, generationuradio.com. You can do that right now. If not, we don't know y'all. We'll be right back after this break, man. It's a Common Sense Show. Turn up.
We had a moment. All right.
You know the deal. DJ J Switch. Beats by Supremo for all of my people, Negroes and Latinos, and even the gringos. Yo, check it, one for Charlie Hustle, two for Steady Rock.
three for the four, come alive, future shock. It's five dimensions, six senses, seven firmaments of heaven to hell. 8 million stories to tell. Nine planets faithfully keep in orbit with the probable tenth. The universe expands length. The body of my sex possess extra strength. Power lifted, powerless, up out of this towering inferno. My aim so hot it burned through the journal. I'm blacker than midnight on Broadway, you're myrtle. Hip hop past all your tall social hurdles like the nationwide project, prison industry complex. Working class poor, better keep your alarm set. Streets too loud to ever hear freedom ring. Say it back in with your sleep. It's dangerous to dream, but your chain cats get they chip back. You dead now. Killing fields need blood to grade the cash cow. It's a number game, but shit don't add up somehow. Like I got 16 to 32 bars to rock it, but only 15% of profits. Ever seen my pockets like 69 billion in the last 20 years spent on national defense, but folks still live in fear like nearly half of America's largest cities is one quarter black. That's why they gave Ricky Ross all the crap. 16 ounces to a pound, 20 more to a key. A 5 minute sentence hearing and you're no longer free. 40% of Americans own a cell phone, so they can hear everything that you say when you ain't home. I guess Michael Jackson was right, you are not alone. Rock your hard hat black as you in the terror zone. Full of hard niggas, large niggas, dice tumblers. Young teens of prison greens facing life numbers. Crack mothers, crack babies, and AIDS patients. Young bloods can't spell, but they can rock you a PlayStation. Snoop Mav is whipping motherfuckers ass. You wanna know how to rhyme, you better learn how to add. It's mathematics.
I've been trying to tell him, man. You wanna? I got a lot of homeboys, you know what I'm saying? They're rapping shit. I told him, man. You wanna learn how to rhyme? You gotta learn how to add, man. Shout out to Most Def, man, with the mathematics.
Oh, I love
hip hop, man.
I love him.
And who got they? Turn your phone off, Melanie. Turn your phone off.
Oh, is that me?
Yeah.
I can't even hear.
Soundproof.
We back. Okay, you could turn my music down a little bit, man. We a little turned up in the building today. Y'all know how we get down, man. Our breaks be off the chain, man. Generation U Radio. We back, man. If you get a chance and you want to call into our show, man, we got the call-in number. It's 323-965-1600. And if you didn't know, man, the place to check us out live is rmconair.com. Shout out to our sponsors again. And speaking of sponsors, man, I'm going to take this time to do my weekly water break. I don't know where the weekly water break ever really came from, but we got a sponsor. Gorilla Life Chlorophyll Drink. Hit him with a round of applause one time. Yeah. And I'm going to go ahead and pass the mic, man. Take it away.
I mean, there's just so many ways to tackle this topic. Like, I don't even know where to start today. Like, we're talking common sense. We're talking book smart versus street smart. Let's just talk about, like, you know, like, where do we get common sense from? Is it in school? Because, I mean, I think that there's some things that you do learn in school.
Supposed to be born with it, in a sense.
Born.
You're born with certain things you have. There's, like, an innate ability you know about certain things. And if you got smart-ass parents, I mean, common sense having parents, then you learn.
I love that. Right.
Some people
ignorance is hereditary.
There's some people who are book smart, but they're dumb as hell when it comes to common sense.
Smart, dumb motherfucker.
Like, you know what I'm saying? They got degrees, but you be like, I would hit you with a bus. Just But you get people like that all the time. Right. You know what I'm saying? I grew up on the south side of Chicago, plain and simple.
Shout out to Chicago
street,
one time.
Street certified. Street certified.
Like, I shouldn't even be here right now. I am
you
a
are.
Survivor. Y'all should be playing Destiny's Child for me.
No, that's right.
I'm a survivor.
I'm a
survivor. Anthem.
But the thing is, you grow up having to have both, being from the south side of Chicago. Mm-hmm. You have to have street smart, of course, because you got to know where to go, who to hang with, who not to be, where not to be. But you got to have book smart also
to get out of it.
To be like, how do I talk to people?
Right.
You know, how do I know how to use the English language? Because I got a bunch of dudes, if I tried to have an actual sophisticated conversation with them, I would slap the piss out of them every 30.
Sophisticated.
First of all, it was a big ass long. That was too many syllables. They was like, oh.
So let me ask you a question then. Like, I mean, because a lot of people say, like, you know, you to have street smart, a lot of people kind of imply that you have to have been somewhere in a street environment. So, like, so if you didn't grow up in a street environment,
I mean, there's a different level of street smarts with different people. Like, there are people who have suburban street smarts. Like, they know how not to fuck
with. Get all the suburban street smart people with round of applause. Y'all got streets too. You know?
They know how to stay away from a cul-de-sac. You know what I'm saying?
Like a cul-de-sac. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Listen, my narrow pathway, I sort of got in the valley.
Stop.
About these things. And, listen, in the valley, there are certain hills and apexes, and we go over this way. And I learned and do some of the same things I learned about.
That was awesome.
That's their way of having street because that's what they know.
Right.
Now, because when we always talk about street smarts, we talk about what people deal with in the hood. Let's be honest. That's the common denominator behind that.
They be having trap houses in the suburbs too.
Trap houses are worth $500,000.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
Houses I want.
They got a good wardrobe and that motherfucker like everything.
Squatter in. Be like, oh my God, are you living in this house? Did you see the floors?
Yes.
Did you see the floors? Right. They still got a granite tub in there.
But I have to disagree with you because I didn't grow up in the hood.
Oh, I could have not been surprised.
The way you say hood gave that away. Hit it with a disclaimer. You're not supposed to put hood in quotations.
I could have not been.
Where'd you grow up at?
I'm actually not from this country, but.
Okay, so where'd you grow up at?
I grew up in a third world country, so I grew up with another.
Which one?
Actually, I didn't grow up
in several third world countries.
You keep not saying where you from.
Here's the question. Did we want to donate you some shit at 2 in the morning off of infomercial?
Excuse me?
Did we want to send your family care packages at 2 in the morning off of infomercial when you say
third world country? No, but you want to come vacation where I was born.
I come vacation where you live.
So you're still not telling us where it was.
What are you talking about? Wait to see where you were born?
Stop it. I was born in Barbados, but I grew up in Nigeria and Brixton in London. So I grew up kind of in the hood, I guess, but not really.
Of those areas?
Yeah. Well, yes and no. I mean, it's...
Because every place has a
hood. By default, those are hoods.
You find a hood in the United Kingdom?
Right.
Well, in London, so London and Brixton.
Is it London in the United Kingdom?
London and Brixton.
Bang, it's in London.
Stop it.
Hey, motherfucker, mate. Hey, motherfucker.
Anyway, my point was, like, can we bring it back? My point was...
Bring your shit, homie.
Give me your wallet and your teas and crumpets. Now, go ahead.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. That's how you know you actually get shanked. But so I didn't grow up. Yeah,
you know what that means
you get shanked by somewhere a cheeky motherfucker. Cheeky. Right. That's what you say there. Cheeky. Hit us.
Anyways, I didn't grow up in the hood, but I still feel that I developed street smarts, not being necessarily social. And then when I moved to the States, I lived in Orange County, you know, so
even better.
Digging that hole deeper.
Right.
Have you seen the movie Holes? Because she keep digging.
I'm gonna go ahead and jump on that bandwagon though, because I kind of feel like those of us who maybe grew up in like a non-hood environment, we're automatically assumed to not. You said what?
She air corded, just you know.
I did it too. But like it's always assumed that you know we don't have common sense, or you know just because I'm from LA I have to be an airhead, or you know all those things.
No, I get exactly, but you're also introduced to people.
Hold it down. Go ahead.
Okay, so you know how like you're living in an area where you're just like, okay, it's not a hood area.
Exactly.
But what if you got the hood people living in those not hood areas?
A little round of applause one time. That happens all the time.
Okay, so Diamond, so you are confirming. So just for clarification, you are confirming that in order to have street smarts, you have to either have grown up in the hood or have interaction with somebody from the hood. So street smarts comes directly from the hood. Is that what we're...
I don't agree with that.
You survive in the hood.
Okay.
If you walk through.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's about how your upbringing, basically. Mm-hmm. You know, that's basically like your upbringing because you have, you know, your family that tells you stories. Right. So you might have to feel like you got to walk around and walk some type of way because your uncle is somebody to these people in this certain area. Certain things like that.
I will say this.
So you're saying exposure.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
Direct or indirect.
Right, because people have those family members who are from the hood. You know what I'm saying? Like, case in point.
You still went back to the hood.
But the hood is always different ways. But see, the hood is always different.
Let him talk.
The hood is always, it's a big spectrum of it, though, when you say that. Because think about it. You got people who live in the suburbs who have the most country bumpkinness of family members that when they come and visit, it's like it's a whole different environment for the kids who've never been introduced to that.
Correct.
Right. So that's where the street, you know what I'm saying? So that happens. But that's considered their hood. Because I got family members from Birmingham, Alabama. If you tell me that these country-ass Negroes is from the hood, I think one will shoot me. But
they are.
But they are, though.
It's a different hood.
It's a different hood.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that's what I'm saying. It's a bigger spectrum of it at the end of the day.
Like, basically, like, to back off, like, what you're saying is, like, I'm originally from Cleveland, Ohio, okay? 216.
God bless you.
Hood.
Can we hit hook?
Straight up hood. You feel me? I got family members in Akron. You know, and to be honest, that's exactly why my mom and dad moved me out here, was to get away from the hood. Because if I was out there, who knows where I would have been at, you feel what I'm trying to say? Mm-hmm. California was just more opportunities out here for me, so I did that. But it goes back to what I said earlier. Yeah, it's like you can move somebody out the hood, but at the same time, you can still be in jail. You can still be locked up in your head and your mindset. You feel me? Because we moved from Cleveland to Orange County, Rancho Santa Margarita.
Get it, girl.
Okay?
That's
a nice-ass
neighborhood, by the way.
That's kind of beautiful. It's beautiful.
But you would think I was from the hood, though.
Did y'all not hit the Jefferson State music bar when she said that?
We don't know, check, but we assume you taught those kids common sense.
Oh, did you potty mouth?
I'm sure she did.
You have to, because at the same time, right. It's like you have to get that respect. I mean, me moving and making that transaction, you feel me? I was like, damn, they're the only black girl within my whole school.
Same here.
That was the very first time I ever got called a nigger and got spit on.
Same here.
So, wow. You know, I was from the hood, but at the same time, I'm still a young girl, so I was, like, hurt by that. You feel me? So I couldn't go hood and beat somebody up, you feel me? But the next time, you feel me, when that happened, I was just like, okay.
You know what, Diamond? That happened to me, too. I used to live in RSM, too, and then some similar shit. I'm not even going to talk about that on the air. Hey, go ahead, Chris. Tell the people what's up.
I just had one thing to say about the street smarts. First of all, she was repping Ohio. I'm from Cincinnati, 513. What's up? All right, everybody, Midwest in the building, bitch. Okay. Anyways, we got Chicago, we got Ohio. Anyway, okay. Now, what I was saying about street smarts is I break it down straight from the word street smarts. It's like, to me, it's like if you're knowledgeable in the streets, like if you all ass got dumped out in the streets or for some reason you became homeless, would you be able to survive?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have the smarts to be able to make it?
So the original topic was common sense, though. So let's move away from street smart. We're talking about common sense.
There's a tie between that, though.
Hey, let me jump in there real quick, because a lot of what street smarts is common sense.
Right. Thank you.
True. It's the same thing in a way.
Yes or no?
Common sense. You can use common sense in the woods. You only use street smarts in the hoods.
That's not common sense does not apply if you're not seeing Naked and Afraid.
So I'm going to have to say something then.
Yeah,
since we're equating common sense with street smarts.
Please do.
So there's a lot of things that happen in the streets that I think aren't so common sense.
Thank you.
Hit it with a round of applause.
Bring it, girl.
Cue my music. I'm sweating in here.
Our people are doing some things that I think would be a little common sense counterintuitive. So I'm just going to have to say that I can't say that common sense is street smarts necessarily.
Yeah, I agree.
Melanie, you got a great point with that. It's Generation U Radio, man. The Common Sense Show. When is common sense? It's not that common, man. Do you have street smarts? Do you got book smarts, or do you got all of it?
All of it.
I got a book that if you really want to, you know, learn something, you should read. It's called The Art of Mastery.
I love that book.
Have you ever heard of The Art of Mastery? Mm-hmm. Great record. Great book. Anyways, cue my music up. Cue my music up from the top.
Pull it up.
From the top. Another one is 33 Strategies of War. That's another one. But anyway, we gonna give y'all a little bit of information. We gonna give y'all a little bit of some ratchet bullshit. That's what we do. It's Generation U Radio, man. At Gen U Radio, if you get a chance, subscribe. The Common Sense Show. We'll be right back after this break.
Shut up. Right around my brand new 99 Fordo and Volvo. I got a pocket full of bees, come with it, ain't got no place to go though. But all my bogan boys, they know though. That's for sure though.
Are those blue gray jeans you're wearing?
Hell nah, ho, you know they polo. I've been used again, accused again. This time been rolled with y'all for something done by one of my youth friends. Soon as they seen the bins, hit the season was in. Hell, cause they ain't feeling me, but not understanding they reason being. Yeah, but I'm the man for this. While y'all been doing fine, I was doing time just praying for this. Locked up, make a plan for this. Without all that fancy shit, way too advanced for this. Got polo socks, tank tops, and drawers up under my pants. Shit. Shut up, uh-huh, okay, what's up? 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 Shut up, uh-huh, okay, what's up?
Okay, who's the baddest bitch? I've been real, been rich, been had this shit. Big biz, big house and shit. That's right, okay, I've been down with Trick. Okay, that makes sense to me, cause if your money ain't right, you're speaking fresh to me. Mistreat, don't play with me. Or you can say Miss Biz, okay with me. need a grand to speak to me. Okay, are you sure you wanna see with me? Okay, you better be for sure, cause I done left niggas like you stuck before. Okay, you can ball with me since you got a hot knot, spend it all with me. Okay, I know what's up. Okay, I ride, shut up.
Okay, what's up? Shut up. Okay, what's up? Shut up. Okay, what's up? Shut up.
Generation, you we back, man. It's a common show, common sense show, man. We back. You can turn my music down just a little bit more. Thank you. That's good right there, man. Hey, I appreciate everybody being in the building today, man. Chris O, thank you, man. Real quick off the top, I wanted to take this opportunity to give you a shout out. The song, right?
Amazing.
Tell the people how they could find your song and your link and how they could download it and what they need to do in order to help you with this thing. Turn the music off. We'll go
with it. All right. Excuse me, my brother. Okay, so I got this song for what? It's doing real well. Music video dropped. It's pretty dope. A lot of people have been checking it out. But basically, I'm in this contest to make a record with Jazzy Faye. And I've made the final round out of tens of thousands of people.
Round of applause.
Can we get a round of applause?
Good job. Good job.
See, I found out because I saw an actual video on his social media with him and Jazzy Faye in the studio. Wow. He's been telling us about it for a while now. Did you wear your bomber jacket?
Listen to his music. Well,
did you wear your...
What color? Brown or
brown?
Yeah, he got the brown one. You got it the old school.
I'm not playing.
All right. That's actually something separate that's coming up. I am working on something else with Jazzy Faye. Through the contest, he was like, yo, shit's hot, so we got something else.
I've been trying to tell people people don't listen because they like, oh, well, he think he dope and shit. Yo, check out Chris O. The song is called For What.
Yes.
That shit is fire.
Go to his page.
Go to my Facebook page, at Chris O Music. You can find me on Facebook, Chris Oliver. I got the single page that says For What. You'll see it. Go ahead and vote. Basically, it's real simple. You scroll down to number 96, you hit For What, submit, and then comment on my video on Jazzy Faye's fan page. Help me win this thing. I win $5,000.
Woo! A song with him. Share with us?
A music video. Definitely, you know it's coming back to
my cut, baby. I need my cut.
I want at least 50.
Y'all was the first ones to put me on. Y'all was the first ones to play the
round of applause.
Thank you for keeping the round of applause on that.
Support the people.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all been supporting, y'all been putting me on, and I appreciate that. So it's going to come back around.
Hey, listen, but you already winning, man, because you're already in the studio regardless, man.
Yeah, you're right. We got some shit coming out. The 2016 takeover is about to get real. Me and Jazzy Faye, we got some shit coming.
So
that's so proud.
My favorite Jazzy Faye record is actually called Can't Stop the Boss. That record with E-40 and Too Short and Don't Worry About My Life.
Anyway, let's keep it.
All
right,
I know.
It's
just so great.
Hold on 1 second. We need to get into these interviews, but we have a caller and we want to make sure that we get to our caller. So I'm gonna start it like this. Generation U Radio caller, what's your name?
Never mind.
We held him too long.
Okay, well, sorry. Thank you for calling.
Thank you for calling. Call back.
Call back, please. Yeah.
Shout out to the dial tone. We gonna keep it pushing.
Yeah, so we definitely have some talented people in the building today. Once again, Chris O, that's amazing.
Congratulations.
And I didn't even get a chance to vote, so I didn't even know. So
I voted.
Doing that tonight.
96.
Yes. Okay.
Oh, we got the call.
Okay, I got you. Yeah. Okay, you. Of course.
I made another vote. Another Facebook. Voted twice.
It won't let me vote three times, but I did vote twice. So right. Just letting you know.
So you can vote every day, right?
Well, every day.
Okay. You used to be able to vote every day.
Now you can only vote once.
And stuff and make automated robots. Mm. And so they changed up the rules now. You can only vote once, and that's so why you can only comment on the video. So
got it.
You voted and commented.
Okay, I'll
got
comment.
It.
I'll go back. Got I didn't it. Comment, so I'll
all
go
right.
back.
So
no
all
problem.
You got to do is vote once. So no excuses.
No problem.
Get your ass up and
I got
help,
my vote
help
in.
The homie
got
support
you.
The people.
All right.
Listen, we got our caller back real quick, so we want to do our caller real quick.
Can
just, go ahead and say the number real quick.
Go ahead.
Say the number.
The caller's online.
Okay, well, we'll do it like this. Generation U Radio. Caller, what's your name? Where you come from?
Hey, man, my name is Adam Frederick.
What's up?
Hi, Adam.
Hey, Adam.
Hit Adam with a round of applause one time, please.
How are you?
I'm well.
I would love it. Hey, you're breaking up a little bit, just so you know.
Oh, sorry, man. Sorry.
Take a walk up some stairs or something.
Common sense versus like ghetto or not. Or hood versus not hood.
Let them go.
I like that.
That's
I don't think that they correlate at all because common sense is like don't put a toaster in the bathtub. But
I'm gonna turn my headphones
the hood in Street Smart are, you know, can I pretty much flip $100 from, you know, zero.
Okay.
So, I mean, I think if you were talking about, like, common sense in the sense of just, like, are we doing the right thing? Like, people who are doing stuff in the hood, are they doing the right thing? Or even if you're not from the hood, are you doing the right thing in your comments?
Hey, hit him with a round of applause. That's a great angle, man.
Exactly.
You're the first caller in 2.5 years that called in with a really good angle. You know what? Not only are we going to listen to what you said.
We have some good callers.
But that was a good one.
I appreciate that. Thank you so much. I like that view, actually. I take that.
Real quick, and not only are we going to take that, tell the people your name one more time and where they can find you.
It's Adam Frederick. You can find me on Facebook pretty much.
And, Adam Frederick.
I really like your show. It's really good. Like, I try to tune in as much as possible. So keep it up.
Thank you,
Adam.
Hit him with a round of applause, man.
Thank you for calling.
Thanks for calling in. And if you get a chance, man, jump on our pages and we'll definitely show you love, shout you out, and everything. And not only are we going to do that, but we're also going to change and adjust our topic.
Shoot me a text so I can hear you.
We're going to adjust our topic to what the people saying. Thank you for calling in, man.
Yeah.
So there's that. He made a good point. There's a difference between street smarts and common sense at the end of the day.
Exactly.
You feel me? So so let's do this. We're going to do our interviews right now. And while we're doing that, let's see if we can jump in on that topic. Let's see what kind of skills we got on the slide.
So I want to talk to Chef Ryan.
Yeah.
All right.
We got
some Southern soul and
Creole,
building.
I believe.
Do you travel? He makes travel Creole around soul? And cook.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Have you done parties?
Hold on.
You traveled to my house.
I'm done.
Have you done house events?
So you're originally from Louisiana.
That's correct.
You specialize in Creole food.
Mm. Yes.
All right. So, like, where did you learn how to cook? Number one.
Hey.
I need to know.
Well, how many places? Yeah. I went to school, Chef John Post Culinary School.
Okay.
Formerly trained.
Professional.
You used to cook for Common. How ironic.
I cook for Common.
I love me some Common.
Hit you with a round of applause. Man. Hit us with a round of
That's
applause.
Common sense.
Talk about tying it in.
I'm
going to take credit as a producer.
So
anyway.
Keep going. I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Common sense.
I've cooked in a lot of restaurants.
And Will Smith.
Worked for Emerald. Okay. Worked at Commander's Palace.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
I worked at La Petite Grocery, Gautreaux, up to Hurricane Katrina. Then I left.
Okay.
Moved to Atlanta.
Okay.
Worked at Emerald's again.
Okay.
Till
I've been to that one.
And so
how was it?
Emeralds? It's not what I thought it would be. I'm sorry, because if you're going to a restaurant with a guy that has a name, you're expecting 5-star. And I don't know if it was the chef on duty that day or, and not to talk shit because the food was still good. It's just, you're expecting 5-star. And the
I ain't
the,
never
the
even,
price
I don't know what 5-star is to
you're
expect.
You're a bougie ass.
You know how I
feel. I just know 3-star.
When you were there, we know you did a great job.
Talk about street smarts.
What I mean by 5-star is my steak was pink enough. It was caramelized. My onions, they was grilled slightly.
Well, I guess dente. All we can conclude
mushrooms
here
sauteed.
Is that when Chef Ryan was there, he had 5-star service.
Yeah,
okay,
I'm sure you did.
That's all
Bill.
We know. All right.
Well, me and you need to throw a party.
Right.
I'm with that.
So,
Game 2's coming up Sunday.
How did you get hooked up with the whole celebrity chef deal? So, how did you get into that?
Well, the whole Will Smith job came through a friend of mine back. Well, went to school with. So that's how we really connected to cooking for him.
How many years?
I cooked for Will for like 3.5 years.
Wow, man.
Did he ever say you couldn't stare him in the eyes? Don't you look Will straight in his eyes.
Did he really say that?
You can't look Will straight in his eyes.
You've heard, you actually don't, heard that?
Was it like the I Am Legend Will, right, or was it like the Fresh Prince Will?
No, it was the Fresh Prince Will.
Okay, I was like, the Fresh Prince Will. Fresh Prince Will with a round of applause.
Damn it, I thought it was the Pursuit of Happiness Will.
He was all right. He was all right.
The one I wanted to see crudges.
Does he have a favorite dish?
I don't think so. No, he just loves to eat.
He's like, whatever you make of.
Whatever it is.
Did he call you Jeffrey?
What about?
No. Jeff.
Did you call him Master William?
That's messed up. What about, Common? Is there anything
Master William.
That he's particularly fond of?
He's vegan.
Oh, is he?
Ooh, no wonder he looks so good.
He was with Erykah Badu and started eating onions.
Common as well. Ooh,
so y'all didn't know when he
up a little bit.
When he was with Erykah Badu, he started eating onions raw.
Stop it.
Hey, it's something about that mystical vagina, Erykah Badu.
It looks amazing. Erykah Badu. I will say that. It looks amazing when she took all her clothes
body
off.
Body went around.
Jesus, an IKEA manger, Lord
I
Father.
I watched it 5 times when it first came out.
So it's a little bit more difficult to cook vegan food.
I had to call Tyrone.
Tyrone Lerone. Man, I asked for window seats on a Megabus thanks to Erykah Badu.
You so stupid.
When it comes to cooking vegan food, is that a little bit more difficult because it's so specialized or
no meat, right?
It's not difficult. No, it's just not exciting.
It's not exciting.
You can't put a bunch of extra.
You can't really shut
just
stuff.
Vegetables. Right.
Exactly. Exactly.
All right. Well, let's get into a little bit of what he actually brought something for us, you guys.
We got some food in
there. I love it.
You want some music in the background? I feel like I need some tunes. Just cue something.
Tell us. We're gonna.
What food you got?
You guys, let's get this under control.
Yeah.
We're gonna eat it on the break, but let us know what it is that we're gonna be tasting.
Yeah, pasta noodles. Pasta noodles.
Can we get the camera?
What's up?
I'm so excited.
So this is a rigatoni pasta.
Oh my god.
Okay.
With shrimp, charred broccolini. I grilled the broccoli.
You said rigatoni.
Roasted tomatoes.
Chef Ryan
looks amazing.
Are you married, Chef Ryan?
Not married. Single.
Single lady.
Hello.
A man that can.
And it ain't no hot dogs in this pasta, y'all. It ain't no hot dogs in this pasta.
He didn't make nothing.
Hey, cue up my music real quick. We're gonna go into this break real quick. We're gonna go into this break. We're gonna get our food and we're gonna come back and finish this out strong, man. It's Generation U Radio, baby. If you get a chance, like I said, support the art, support the people, support the movement. We'll be right back. If you get a chance, support the pasta, support the chefs. I am legend. We'll be right back after the break, baby.
Support
Carl. I need a 100 gold. Look at the flick of their wrist. 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 I woke up feeling like I was on the moon. I woke up feeling like I need a 100 goons. Some niggas in my sleep trying to catch a beat. Some bitches in my six trying to fuck for free. Catch it, play on these niggas, touchdown. I'm my own quarterback, put my team on. Luxury, that's all I see. Look at the flick of that wrist, got them on me. I don't see niggas. California loud, got me lit, nigga. I'm the shit, nigga. Take a bitch, nigga.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Generation U Radio, we back.
So what's that tasting like? Anybody tasting it yet?
Chef Ryan.
Is it good?
Chef Ryan, will you marry me? Because if you're going to be giving this to me every night.
Listen, Chef.
You something every night.
Every
that's
night.
That's what she's like picking up clients.
Like your bullshit.
So if anybody.
What y'all do, as long as I can be in the kitchen, y'all can take whatever else.
So if anybody wants to know a little bit more about what he's doing, you are, okay, so you're two things. You're working on the recipe. book.
Well, this ties into both things.
Hey, that's okay, good.
It's delicious.
And the other is the YouTube.
Can we get a video.
YouTube channel, right?
Working on a YouTube channel. Working on that also.
Okay.
Working on a spice line.
He said it's rigatoni.
So this is the citrus herb rub, which is going to be coming out this month.
Ooh.
Coming out with a ancho chili barbecue rub. Also coming out with a Nola Creole rub.
Okay.
Yo, tester.
Chef Ryan.
I'll test it.
So we get to have your stuff in our kitchens now. Yes. So we now can have our own Chef Ryan products in our own home.
And y'all, yes.
Get it.
That is amazing.
That's an amazing accomplishment.
Hit him with a round of applause.
Commercials.
Tell us where we can learn more, or like, so when the line is done, where we can get it. Just let us know all the information.
Okay. You can follow me on my website. It's Rondeno Culinary Designs.
Okay.
Or you can Instagram me, NolaChef212, or Facebook me, Chef Ryan Rondeno.
Okay. So,
Rondeno, spell that.
Yeah.
Rondeno.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Just making sure, because for our illiterate fans.
Oh, okay.
You know, it's common sense.
Yeah. Right.
Hit it with a
right. Okay. All right. Well, speaking of common sense, and since we're talking about like social media and whatnot, I have a question now, and I kind of want to throw this out to everybody. What role do you think that the media in general has played in our common sense in society, right, or our level of
shout
common sense?
Shout out to Fox News, real quick.
Right.
Man, please don't bring them up, bro, because their followers are the most oblivious individuals on the planet.
Wow.
Fox News and anybody who watches this dude, Alex Jones,
are the most
oblivious people on God's
ignorant
green earth.
Is the word.
No, I don't even want to give him that much credit.
Wow.
Because I got a dude who I used to be buddies with for like 10 years. I used to be a professional wrestler.
Okay.
And we were cool until he started following.
We're going to get back to
that.
We're going to talk about that. Keep it moving. This is a great segue into your interview.
But we'll talk about that. But like, dude follows Alex Jones like vehemently. Mm-hmm. Again, biggest syllables. That's why I can't handle
it. I'm gonna let you go though. Keep it.
But
I understand that.
Like, dude will say some of the most asinine things that aren't proved.
Absolutely.
Proven at all. There's no factual basis on it. Like, he'll just say, we've got proof that this is happening and it's going on in the Senate right now, and nothing is proven. Right. It's just like everything he says, and it's people who are just as conspiracy theory based as he is.
Right.
And then those are the same type of Fox News viewers who be like, see, this is why everything is happening. Look, there are certain things that happen in this country and this world that we don't know about, granted.
Mm-hmm. And if you guys don't know who he's talking about, it's the same guy who posted when Michael Clark Duncan passed away, and he posted Terry Crews' picture.
That he swore me like, wow.
It was ridiculous. I was like, what is happening?
Right. He sounds like a Donald Trump supporter.
Adamant Trump supporter.
They definitely terrible, and it's so sad for them, but I don't got time to be talking about these dudes. But I do want to talk about this, man. I see that you was in the Chirac movie.
Oh, right.
Yes, sir.
Hit them with a round of applause one time. How was it? What was your role, man?
I was one of the co-stars, man. I got to play Wesley Snipes' right-hand man, Beast Almighty. We were like we were heads of the gang of the Trojans. A lot of people, you know, call flack from, especially being from the south side of Chicago, because they wanted something else. They wanted Menace to Society 2. They wanted Boys in the Hood, the sequel. Mm. And forgetting that when you're talking about Spike Lee, you're not going to get that. He already did Clockers.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
He's not going to do another one.
He's not going to do anything like that.
Like, as good as it could.
Here's the thing. The problem is,
sequels are never as good as the original. Anyway.
Not at all. Depending on which ones. Okay.
Terminator 2 was a beast.
Captain America 2 and 3.
Captain America. Home Alone 2 was dope.
Home Alone 2
was dope. The original was the best.
Final Destination started making me reevaluate everywhere I travel.
I know that's right. I don't take the freeway no more.
If I was on the freeway and saw a log truck, I'm like, we're going to get on.
I don't even need to drive right now.
Rescuers Down Under.
What?
What the fuck?
Sorry, everybody just lost it.
Team light skin. Anyway, right. Hey, Chris, I feel you.
Real quick,
we got a caller, and I'm pretty sure it's for Chris. So hold on one second, man. We got another caller, Generation U. Caller, what's your name? Where you calling from?
Denzel.
What?
Denzel?
Oh, that's your name?
Yes.
Hit Denzel with a round of applause.
We got Denzel on the line.
Denzel Washington?
Yes.
Ooh.
I wish.
You pay him?
Denzel.
Hey, man, what's your name? You want to chime in on the topic, man? Go ahead. Talk your shit, man.
Let's talk about King Kong.
I just wanted to let you know that I voted for you, and I just want to say good luck with the Magic Bay contest.
He voted for you.
You talking to Chris? Hey, Chris, come on the mic real quick.
Yeah, get on the mic.
Come on the mic.
Chris can't even hear, though.
I can't hear shit.
He's going to talk to somebody he can't communicate with.
Put the hands on. Hey, my man.
Say it again, Denzel.
Say it one more time.
Denzel.
Yes.
What up? You voted for me, man.
Yes, I voted for you.
Hey, I appreciate you, homie. Thank you. That's the Chris O movement in full effect. What's up, bro? And thanks for calling in, bro. I appreciate that, for real.
All right, no problem.
Thanks, Denzel. Thank you, Denzel.
All right.
We're going to keep it pushing real quick, man. Like I said,
that's actually me rapping.
Stop it.
Hey, man, we got Jay Washington in the building.
Yeah.
We got Chef Ryan in the building.
Yeah.
We got Trainer Cakes in the building.
Hello.
Chris O in the building. Mm. Chris Hudson in the building. We got my DJ, Jay Swish in the building. Don't forget the A-Y.
I'm a little slim.
Jay Washington, so yes. We were talking about Chirac and whatnot. I just want to ask your personal theory on, do you have a potential solution to the whole situation?
Like, it's easy. I mean, the answer is so addressed and so put out there, it's almost redundant, but not to say when you're asking it. It's the fact that there needs to be more after-school programs. There needs to be more money allocated to the south side of Chicago.
Yes.
Being a resident who was born and raised, this is the first place I've ever lived outside of the south side of Chicago.
Oh, wow.
So I know what the city goes through.
Okay.
Let me ask you one more question about that, because I've been dealing with a lot of this. I got some people out in Chicago, that one area that doesn't have a hospital, bro. What would you do, like, if you had the power? You know what I'm talking about, right?
They got
to redistrict just to take guys to the hospital.
Yeah, all these
gunshot victims, so they don't even want to treat.
It's a certain place, because there's only one triage unit.
Really? In the whole major, south side of Chicago?
One major triage unit. I believe that's Christ Hospital.
Next to Chicago University, but they shut days down, right?
No, you're talking about what used to be Providence, that's over there close to Chicago, the university.
Right.
Right. Providence was on 51st. The university is like 55th. So about a four-block difference.
My bad.
No, no problem at all. Yeah. But they shut down Providence, and so that took away one of the major Southside triage hospitals.
Oh, wow.
So
wow.
If you got shot in that area, you had to be transported basically to the other side across the bridge and across the city.
How long does that take?
Depending on traffic. We're talking about Chicago traffic any time of the day.
So wait, no, how far is the hospital is what I'm saying from that area?
Sometimes traffic 15, 20 minutes. And that's on an easy...
And you're bleeding out.
And that's on an easy ambulance ride with clear traffic.
Wow.
You see what I'm saying? Wow. It's not a 5-10 minute run where you're in and out and we can stabilize you and get it all done.
So I saw stuff on the internet where they were talking about it was taking them an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
And the hour and a half was just to have the ambulances show up.
Right. That's unacceptable.
And the problem is...
Because they got to come from there.
No. That's not even the case.
Because it's the hood.
It's the hood. There are firehouses in a lot of the hoods where if a call comes out, they can be there.
But they don't got the whole triage, huh?
No, they don't care. They don't care. There's a difference.
Speak on it. They don't care.
The thing is, you have it where I'm on a block and maybe 3-4 blocks over. If I'm a firehouse that houses the fire trucks and the ambulances and the EMTs, I hear 3-4 blocks over there's been a shooting. Sometimes you have the EMTs and I'm like, listen, are they done shooting yet?
What?
Wow. Let me know when it's done.
Wow.
When it's done, when we think it's all clear, then we'll go. Let me know when the police say we can come over there now.
Wow.
Because as soon as they get the call, they're not rushing over there unless the police are called or unless they say it's an officer down.
What happened to me?
Yeah, it's an officer down, though.
Oh, of course, it's everybody out, as it should be.
And they taking niggas to jail.
No matter what, you just sitting around looking.
Yeah.
But it's gotten so bad, the economic downturn, because a lot of times there's different neighborhoods where you're like, oh, this community doesn't look that bad. There's stores and there's these different things here, but guess what? None of them are owned by the community.
Right.
Wow.
Right.
I grew up in a community where all of them were Middle Eastern based. Wow. It was a bunch of cell phone stores, liquor stores, grocery stores, everything, and they're all Middle Eastern based. So that money doesn't come back to the community. It goes back to those communities.
Right.
And remember, these people are tax-free for 7 years.
Seven years,
and what happens after 7 years up? You transfer the deed and the titles to your family member who's tax-free again 7 years.
And you keep rolling that.
That's how all hoods are, really, because, I mean, in L.A., who owns liquor stores, I mean, and all the beauty supplies? Koreans.
Who owns gas stations?
Koreans. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I mean, it's...
Hit us with a disclaimer. Yeah, not all Koreans own gas stations.
Not all Koreans.
I'm sorry.
As a whole,
one person. Yeah,
yo, but as a whole, we don't own what's in our communities. We may have, and here's the problem too. You may have one or two businesses that are black owned. The problem being, I'm going to say this, how do I want to say this in the nicest way possible? Niggas don't want to support them to the fullest way possible.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. I know too many dudes who have stores, and the first thing they come in, hey, how much you going to give me this for?
Yeah, that's real.
Pay the face value that they got, because if you go somewhere else, you got to pay the face value no matter what.
Right.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I'm saying? So support them the same way you would support somebody else outside your community.
Right.
So
that's true.
Okay, can I say something with
yeah,
that
talk.
One? I gotta say something with that one because I feel you 100% support them. But at the same time, if we're coming to you, I have to speak on it because I go to a lot of the black communities and you know, in my neighborhood. At the same time, sometimes when you go to the stores and the owners there, they actually sometimes look at you and try to get over on you.
Oh, absolutely.
I feel some type of way because I'm like, yo, I'm trying to keep the money in the hood. I'm trying to support my brothers, my sisters.
Absolutely.
And you're trying to get over on me.
Wow. Absolutely. But you know, it's a two-way street, and then here's the problem. Everybody isn't educated and up to date when it comes to business and economics.
Right. Mm-hmm.
They don't understand how socioeconomics work. How when you keep money in the hood, it develops your community as a whole. Not even just the hood.
Keep
it in your community, it develops your community. Mm-hmm. When you go outside of your community, you don't support your community.
No.
Granted, you can say, oh, I'm supporting a black person who has a business halfway across town. Yeah, that's good. You're supporting a black business across town, but guess what? That money is across town, not where it should be. And especially if you have that same type of business, those same resources in your community, support it there. A lot of people don't do that. But again, people are run everywhere else.
It's also quality of business. You can't just say support black business and then they're not.
Believe me, I'm not going to ever dismiss that.
Because
I'm the first dude who will put a business on blast and I care less.
Yeah, let's be real.
I was born with a mouthpiece to talk the biggest shit in the world.
Exactly.
And I care less if you run a business and you are unprofessional.
Exactly.
Because here's the thing. I have degrees in business.
Right.
Just because I'm a comedian, just because I'm an actor, professional wrestler, all that. That doesn't mean you think you're going to out-talk me when it comes to business.
That's a hell of a combo.
Yeah, I like that.
Mean you're going to out-talk me that way.
Give him a round of applause.
Yep,
thank you.
You know you got to have them talking skills in wrestling. You got to have the talking skills, too.
I feel
thing is, I feel you.
What's a rock? Is. But you know what I'm saying? So people, so when you come at them like that, it's a shock because they're like, oh, I own a business. Yeah, well, how are you running your business?
Exactly.
What kind of a business? Exactly.
You know, what was the bottom line you paid for all this? So what is your profit? Are you trying to surcharge
this
item?
It's not about that. It's about
No, your professional is right, because if you come at me bogus, then I'm going to hit you on your bottom line. Exactly. Oh, are you surcharging this 300% just to try to make an amazing profit?
Exactly.
What do you mean? How much did you pay for this wholesale? How much are you paying per unit for this?
What's a wholesale?
No, they know.
They know.
Yeah, but they know because the thing is, the cats in the hood, those that are unprofessional, they know exactly what you're talking about, and they hate it when you can call them on it.
Exactly.
Like, yeah, and I'm like, uh-huh. Mm-hmm. So since you want to try to act like I'm dumb because of maybe how I dress, how I walked in the store, before you even heard anything, how I speak, now you're feeling really fucking stupid when I'm calling you out on your bottom line, on your numbers, on your debits and credits. Mm-hmm. Oh, what does your bookkeeping show? You know, what was your last quarter numbers? How were you fiscally? What do you mean?
Fiscally.
So there's a disconnect.
Year. There's
another
disconnect.
Absolutely.
Another
one. How many quarters is in a year? How many quarters is in a year?
I'm here with you on this.
Welcome back to being just a regular comedian telling jokes.
Right.
Jay, you losing Scott over here. Sure. He's not understanding all your big words.
I got this big ass phone screen. I'll put all these words up.
All right. So
two letters at a time.
Before we wrap this up, we just want to know about some of the things that you have going on today. Like where can we find you?
Oh, man. I'm currently being played. Stand up. You can hear Stand Up of Minds on SiriusXM on Foxhole Radio. I got stand up plays all the time on that. Yeah, I got stand up plays on that. I'm the co-host of the Trusty Sidekick podcast. What that is, it's a podcast with myself and Bobby Hill. We're both comedians. He's from Chicago. I'm from here. Well, I'm from Chicago. From here now.
Hey, wait a second. The whole interview.
But we only thing we do as two comedians, we cover all the Marvel and DC TV shows and movies. Only that.
Oh, I love that.
And I got a bunch of
money. Oh, I see with your shirt on. You got the Flash shirt on.
Okay. Shout out to my buddy Tone Bell, who plays Scott Evans on the Flash.
Oh, yeah.
I got a bunch of friends who are on the DC show. Shout out Katrina Law. She plays Nisa Al Ghul on Arrow. She was in Spartacus.
I'm just joking with you. Keep going,
she'll say that far from here now. I do that. Also, like I said, I'm in Chirac. There's another movie coming out this year I'm in called Imperfections with Ed Begley Jr., Virginia Call, Aston Holmes, Zach McGowan, Mary Lou Hanna. I'll actually be heading out this Sunday. They got me on a red eye flight, but I'm heading back home to Chicago to film another movie called Landline with Tom Arnold.
Shit, he got a movie with Tom Arnold. I know that.
Cersei, Betsy Brandt from Breaking Bad, Jim O'Hare, Louis Lombardi from 24 and The Sopranos. So I'm doing that.
Good job, Jay.
He
go to my gym.
Man.
I'm just talking shit.
I wouldn't be surprised. Out here in L.A., you don't know who. Like, you know what? I seen this mug at Ralph's the other day.
Yeah.
He was getting some wholesale kale. What? Why kale?
Why kale, though? Stop it.
Wholesale. But yeah, I got that going. I just did I shot something for Star Wars Day for the Nerdist Network. I got some coming out that I shot for YouTube Red. I'm about to start working on something with All Def Digital. So I'm just out here just putting myself. I got here 6 months ago and I haven't stopped running since I touched down.
That's what you do. So, that's what you do.
I know people been here 20 years and still ain't done one project.
You'd be surprised. You see my Facebook inbox. I got buddies that have been friends of mine who are comedians for like 20 years. They've done Comic View, Def Jam, everything. And they're great friends of mine, mentors and role models. And they hit me up. They're always inboxing like, dude, how is it that you are one of the very few people who touched down and didn't wait for a handout?
Because you a hustler. Wow. You got that street smarts.
You know, they was like,
they didn't wait
for a handout. You didn't want nobody to have to give you anything. You worked for it all. And everybody who follows me on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook know I have a hashtag that says work and network.
Hey.
Because that's how I live my life. I work and I network with everybody. Like, I mean, I understand, you know, being in LA and the entertainment capital.
You're going to get tired of these motherfuckers after a while. But right. You're going to be like, you know what? I don't feel like networking today.
Bro, I keep 6 shots on deck just for that. But, you know what I'm saying? I understand that, you know what I'm saying, but you got to do, you know, it's a lot of politics, but I also network my behind so people know, like, oh, I can work with him and make money off him and he can make money off me.
Exactly.
It's workable.
Right. It's mutually beneficial.
Mutually beneficial to everybody. So yeah, I'm doing all that, man, and just out here and I'm having fun with y'all on the show. So y'all, let's
hit him with a round of applause.
And he is
come back.
That when you pair the street smart with the book smart, okay, so you
it
can
work out for you.
You're hitting us with your big words.
I'm sorry, I started reading the dictionary when I was 3. That's literally one of my
tricks. Hey, listen, I gotta get this bullshit together because we gotta go. got like about 3.5 minutes. Man, syllables though, man. Hey, legendary performance today, man. Hey, hilarious.
My brother, I take my, appreciate you.
My skull cap's off for you.
Not really.
We got
Courtney
in the building. Courtney with a round of applause one time.
She came to close out the show, y'all.
We're gonna end it in the black.
What's up, Courtney Black in the building?
What happened to you, Miss UCLA?
Tell the people what happened. Tell the people what happened.
So the guy, there was a shooting at UCLA this week a couple of days ago. A guy shot a professor. He shot his wife, some other people.
Oh, no.
He ditched the car in my neighborhood. Ooh, LA is so exciting. So they thought there was a bomb in his car. It was like they shut down. It was just crazy. Oh, but the best thing, when I was driving here, I passed a police guy in a bomb van, right? It said, like, bomb squad on his van. So I said, hey, did you guys find a bomb? And he was like, no, we didn't. Well, you.
Round of applause, please.
That means Courtney's going out tonight.
Like, I need to get seen today. Hold on.
We appreciate you in the building, girl.
Yeah, Courtney Black Comedy. Funny First Sundays this Sunday at the J Spot. Yes. Thank you.
We'll
guys.
Be there.
Do I drop all the social media stuff too?
Do it.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to start with you anyway. Go ahead.
I was going to do it before you walked in the door with your lip gloss popping. Find me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat at Mr. J Washington, MrJaywashington, JWashington.com is the website. The Trusty Sidekick on Facebook, TrustySidekick.Libsyn.com. All that good stuff, man.
Hey, man, if you want me on your podcast, I don't know.
Definitely have you, bro. We'll talk.
I don't know nothing about comic books.
No, I do. It's not the comic books. That's the thing. It's only about the TV shows, movies. So, like, Gotham, Marvel, Captain, all that. That's all.
I watched Daredevil, too.
You see how they going?
You see how everybody jumped in? Like, oh, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Hey, listen. I'm a nerd over here.
Thank you for being in the building. We're going to talk off the air.
Yes, sir.
We're going to definitely talk off the air. Hey, Chris, tell the people, we got to hurry up and go around the room. We're running late, man. Let's hurry this up.
Yo, I'm going to keep it short. At Chris on Music, please go vote for me on Jazzy Face fan page. You can find me number 96 for what?
Woo!
Comment on the music video, 2016 Takeover. Oh shit, it's coming. At Chris on Music, at Chris on Music, at Chris on Music.
Let me jump in there real quick. Chris, if they want to follow you, they can go onto the Team Lightskin page. If you go on Facebook, onto the groups, type in Team Lightskin, all one word. You'll find his post on there and you can vote there. If you can't find it on there, go on to our social media, Genu Radio, or go on to mine personally, Scott Taylor on Facebook. That's where I do most of my stuff. I don't know nobody on Instagram. Y'all find me on Facebook though. So Team Lightskin, you can find that.
Chris
vote
Oliver.
For Chris Oliver for
Team
what?
Lightskin.
So amazing to see your journey, Chris.
Good job.
So
good job, Chris.
Train a cake.
Train a cake.
You the man, G. You the man in the streets.
You my boy, Blue.
Let me hold something.
Go ahead. Tell people to
Trainer Cakes at Trainer Cakes. I'm your personal trainer.
Get it, Blue.
Stars, you know.
Y'all
booty.
Better follow
booty
her,
don't
man.
Quit. Follow me.
Her booty don't quit.
We don't need to follow her down the street.
Oh, Jesus. Yes, Lord, precious baby Jesus.
Boy, bye.
All right, hey, Chef.
All right.
Chef, tell the people.
Twitter and Facebook at Chef Ryan Rondeno. Instagram at Nola Chef. Website, Rondeno Culinary Designs.
Yeah,
follow me.
The pasta was amazing,
so
Chef
good.
Ryan.
Yes.
So good.
Amazing.
It was not the food I had at...
Emeralds.
Just, you know, disclaimer.
And you can see how hard she is to impress, so you should be good.
It wasn't quite 5-star service.
Shut up. Anyway, hey, listen.
5-star restaurant.
I want to hook you up real quick, man. Shout out to Chef Ryan. If you get a chance on Twitter and IG, follow him. You know what I'm saying? He's a celebrity chef. He's a Creole cuisine.
You give me my chef.
Creole cuisine.
He has a book coming out.
He got a book coming out.
Credentials
to be my chef. Cool.
We appreciate you being in the building.
We're doing a pop-up next month.
Yeah, pop-up.
I don't know nothing about those.
I know, right?
Nice to meet you. Okay. Gotcha. Hey, can I get my DJ on the mic one time, real quick?
Yes.
Tell the people what's up with you.
Oh, I'm out of here.
Just go on her head.
Yeah, it's your boy Jay Swish. I don't got the camera on me, but it's all good. There it
is. What's up, big fella? Big fella.
You feel me?
Follow me. Make sure his angles are right.
I gotta make sure. Okay.
You know he a 90s baby. Hit him with a round of applause. You know he a millennial.
Right. Oh, yeah. It's your boy Jay Swish. Follow me on Instagram at DJ _ Jay Swish. Don't forget the AY. JAY Swish. You feel me? We're going to be out this Sunday at the J Spot on Manchester. Start at 7. I'm DJing. I'm with Courtney Black and Leanne Tooker. It's going to be so funny. You already know.
Funny First Sunday.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he is.
Hey, can I get Leanne on the mic real quick one time, please? She needs to shout out something.
I was going to shout out the same thing. It's been shouted out. You got to come to the J Spot Sunday night. That's
where
we
gonna
all
be there?
Yeah, I'm making you spend more money, but I love
We're
y'all
coming.
That's
coming.
Right. Fill the room,
as a
bitches.
Unit.
Yeah, we will be.
Team diversity in the house.
If I wasn't on a flight, I'd come out. If I wasn't on a flight and back cross country, I'd be out.
You better get out here.
You better get your Wi-Fi and just
My flight is at 1 in the morning.
I got one more thing to say, too. My girl Potty Mouth. My girl Potty Mouth and I, we're going to have some collabs. You can check them out at hashtag Potty Mouth and Tooks. T-O-O-K-S. Right now, it's just a collaboration of cute photos.
Ooh.
But coming soon, we're going to have some other shit, too. So you better go on there and like our photos. Okay.
I got something to say to Potty Mouth. Potty Mouth, what's up with your line, though? Like, you holding it. You holding it.
Workout gear,
right,
Potty Mouth.
Me, don't mean to take all the room. Don't mean to take all the space. No.
Yes, you do.
Hey, Diamond, I like your hat.
Look, you I love your hat, Diamond.
This summer is about to pop. It's been a turn up. I'm working on my EP. I'm working on my own beats. I'm working on my bars.
And the line.
I got my clothing line coming out, too. You feel me? I got the onesies. I got the crew necks. I got
fitness?
Hat. And I got some tanks. Oh. And I got sports bras coming for the summer.
Sports bras, Lord.
Hey,
all the homies looked up.
What? Jesus.
What?
We know
the
law.
So please get at me, you guys, for more information.
Booty shorts.
All right. Cue my music up. Hey, Will, tell the people where they can find you. We got to hurry up.
You can find me right here. You see me now. Goodbye.
You can find me at physical therapy on...
You can find me at physical therapy on Tuesday. Getting right like Kobe.
Hey,
you know what I'm saying?
Get it back.
Yeah, you can find me at Instagram and Twitter at @WilliamB1. You can find me at Facebook, William Basham.
Hey, follow the homie, man. Hit him with a round of applause.
Always posting some wild
Hit
shit.
The homie with a round of
so,
applause.
Yeah. Because I'm sitting on my couch not doing shit. So please and be entertained like I'm being entertained. I'm entertaining myself. But, anyways. And I'll see you at game two.
This Sunday. Let's get it.
Go ahead, Naya. Tell people.
Naya B. You can find me on Instagram and on Facebook.
Looking great today.
Thank you, baby.
Yeah, looking good.
Brown Eye013 on Instagram and Naya B on Facebook and on Snapchat, because you know Trina Geeks follows me. She knows what's up.
I know what's up.
We appreciate you being in the building.
Let's
let Courtney get in.
I'm a guy tonight. You can check my Instagram. I'm in Gardena. I'm with Jamario McClain. Got a hot show in Gardena. It's like a free drink until 8:30 or something.
Tonight?
Yeah,
it's already 7:30, boo.
Oh, is it? I don't know what time it is. Maybe it goes to 9.
You better get your drink now.
I'm on a 30-day cleanse. I'm trying to get his body right for my birthday.
Look at her. Hit him around.
You turning 21? You turning 21?
Wow. Anyway, sorry. So Friday, Gardena, CourtneyBlackComedy.com, CourtneyBlackComedy on Instagram.
J-Spot next week.
This Sunday, oh, J-Spot. Okay. That's my own show, my own production. Y'all support it, girl.
Hit him with a round of
applause. This Sunday, boo.
Tell him Friday.
I'm not working, but I'm a support.
I'm going to come through, definitely.
I'm not an athlete. I'm an athlete.
I'll make it quick. Once again, this is Melanie Eke, and you can find me on Facebook and Twitter at Melanie C. Eke, Eke spelled E-K-E, and I'm also on Instagram at Melanie Chantel. Eat more donuts. Yeah. Enjoy your weekend.
I know that's right.
With your fat ass.
Get those sweets in.
Melanie, I see you with your khaki poncho. She got the poncho on. It's slightly khaki.
Poncho.
It's slightly khaki.
She got the hood attire on. She got the wife beater underneath.
She
so
did.
She hiding it though.
She ain't got one button on a flannel though.
Yeah. Pull your shoulders out, man.
Class it up.
Pop your thighs out.
Yes, you do.
Listen, man, that's a wrap, man. The Common Sense Show, man. Thank you to all of our guests that's in the building, you know what I'm saying? Like Jay Washington.
Thank you, man.
We got Chef
Shout
Ryan.
Out to Kim.
We got my man Will. We got Potty Mouth. We got everybody in the building, man. Courtney Leanne. Everybody, man. Chris. I appreciate everybody being in the building. If you get a chance, make sure to subscribe. Genu Radio on YouTube. Vote for Chris O's song For What. Shout out to my DJ Jay Swish, man.
Right.
I appreciate you being in the building, baby.
My name is Scott Taylor.
My name is Scott Taylor, man. Scotty Trippin. If you get a chance, you want to check out my music, it's scottytrippin.com. SCOTTIETRIPN.com. And we out here for the people.
Bars.
If you don't remember anything else about this show, man, remember these three things. Support the art. Support the people. Support the movement.
Movement.
Happy Donut Day, man. We'll be back next week.
Let's go, Bernie.
Yeah.
A Another day, another rhyme, ho. Another day, another time zone. Today I woke up feeling horny, so it's only right I got two bitches playing on my trombone. Keep up, never sure where the words will take me. Niggas eat them up, no regurgitate me. Shit trunk tight, never slurred, lazy. Give a virgin the urge to rape me, nigga, please. Best friends really make great for enemies. My watch game, niggas can't wait for one of these. I see, nigga, this ain't no Rolex, it's an AP, nigga. I'm hot dog, catch up to me, nigga. Couldn't resist. Aim for the stars and I shouldn't have missed. But I was riding on fumes, so I stopped by the moon. Now I'm sitting.